Yes, go ahead, Nilotpal Basu.
First of all, Mr. Ghosh is saying that he joined the group as a media journalist, as a professional. Can he explain the entire media, print as well as television, why they were having a blatant pro-TMC line if there was no complicity between the TMC and the state government and this group? One. Secondly, he was saying that the government is taking new initiative. Last year, the opposition, the leader of the opposition, wanted to move an adjournment motion to discuss the very disturbing situation about the manner in which the chief funds are functioning in the state.
Yeah.
So why he was not allowed, and when he raised the question, why were the opposition MLAs, the CPI MLAs, beaten up inside the house? All entire media has reported about this. How does he explain that to that extent the government went to defend the, and to shield the activities of the chief funds from public discourse?
Straight question from the CPM. Answer that, Kunal Ghosh.
Number one, Mr. Basu, number one, everybody, every media can have their own policy. Every media can have their own policy. We have different medias. We have Anandamayar Patrika, Bortoman, Ganashakti, Aajkal, everybody has. So you can't ask me why my media, why my articles, why our channel is pro-government or
No, but you just so said you just said you're independent, so you admit you're pro-government. You just admit that you're pro-government. You admit you're pro-TMC in your approach. You're a Trinamool Congress member of parliament. Nilotpal Basu, that question. Second question goes in, and Anindita, I want to bring you in on this. Second question which is asked here is that, is it true that when there were attempts made to raise this issue on the floor of the assembly, then the Trinamool Congress did not allow
it? No, that was a different political situation.
What political?
Or no, that was a completely different political situation.
What was different?
That was a completely political
situation. What was different? What was different?
What Nilotpal Basu?
When was it? When did it happen?
True, absolutely.
When did it happen?
No, that is absolutely an incident from assembly.
Sir, I am.
Nilotpal Basu told that is not.
Sir, I am asking you.
Kunal Ghosh. Not connected. He is trying to divert the issue.
Mr. Ghosh, I am not trying to divert the issue.
Yes.
I am on the issue. And the issue is that you're a journalist. I am a journalist as well. I am not, and don't ever aspire to be a member of parliament. Answer my question. The question is this, Mr. Ghosh. Please listen to me. In September 2011, your party man writes a letter to the Prime Minister. After that, he is marginalized in the party. Okay? In February, SEBI writes to the West Bengal government.
I understand that.
No action.
You are referring 2011. Why you are not referring last few decades?
I am asking why
you are referring 2011?
Sir, because you are in power.
They have invested in Bengal.
Because
in other states, there are so many employments.
Mr. Kunal Ghosh, let me remind you, the Reserve Bank of India governor has clearly stated, and I quote, chit funds are into multi-level marketing and the responsibility of checking and prosecuting them is with the state government. It's your responsibility. You are working with a group that runs a Ponzi scheme.
And who? Before anybody collapses, how can you understand that who is
because Somen Mitra, your party man, wrote to the Prime Minister?
What can you do? A system has been running for.
Why
so
did
many
you no? Why did you
so
not?
Many
what system? What system?
To that.
What system?
How can
what
a
system?
New government take a
what
new
system?
Step?
What
they
system?
Are trying to
what system, sir?
Pragmatic.
Sir, what system? Your Trinamool MP writes to the Prime Minister saying there are dangerous times ahead in the state. He says there is a threat from chit funds. After that, SEBI writes to your government, allow me to complete, saying there are irregularities in the Sharada group. Had the chief minister, had your government reacted earlier and not now, only because panchayat elections looms large. Now panchayat elections looms large. She realizes there is bound to be a...
No information about that.
Sir, you may not have information. Sir, you are a journalist. You choose to have information in some cases, not in others.
Very sad.
Anindita. Yes, Anindita.
No, I really feel disappointed. You know, I used to read a lot of Kunal Ghosh's editorials. I thought he's a very sharp journalist. It seems he has no curiosity from where the money is coming. You know, he was drawing a salary of 38 lakh per month, 15 lakhs in check and rest in cash. There were 141 hoardings with his face. All over Kolkata, he became a producer of film.
Let her complete, I'll come to you.
But she never bothered to find out where the money is coming from.
Arnab, if our colleague in any live chat uses continuous lie, I can't continue with her. If you ask me any question, constantly using lies.
She is saying, you are understanding, Mr. Ghosh.
I tried my best.
I can prove what you are saying.
Anindita, you first reply, who are the investors of 24 Ghanta? Anindita, there are allegations of that online lottery. They are backing your channel 24 Ghanta.
The point is, Kunal Ghosh. Mr. Ghosh, one minute. Can I ask you something? Anindita, one minute. Kunal Ghosh.
You are trying to personally hit me. This is a completely political attempt. I will not continue.
Mr. Anindita, 1 minute and Kunal Ghosh, calm down. 1 minute, allow me to anchor the program.
I am ready to answer all of your questions.
Now, Kunal Ghosh, listen to me. Mr. Ghosh.
You are trying to drag this issue totally politically.
Mr. Ghosh, my question to you is this. Anindita, 1 minute. Let me ask the question, please. One minute, please. Mr. Ghosh, I am asking you one thing. Allow me to ask you, right? First of all, I just want to come in here. I know the tempers are very hot. I know that different points of view are there. I request Anindita also. Let's focus on the issue. The issue is this. See, I am not making any charges, but you are a journalist. You know that it is my responsibility to ask you this question as straightforward way as possible. And the very fact that you are on the program and you're answering the questions is proof of the fact that you appreciate the fact that you are being given an opportunity to present your point of view. Now, my question to you is this, which is a question that Anindita Sarbadhikari is also indirectly raising. The question is this, Mr. Kunal Ghosh, you are saying, I don't know anything about this group's illegal money operations.
Any of the agents or any of the employees of that entire group, whether Kunal Ghosh attended any meeting, any seminar, any operation of that company. I never attended, I never connected with them. Will your party back you?
Will your party support you or will you become a scapegoat?
No. I have full faith on my party.
Have you spoken to Mamata Banerjee?
I have full faith on my party. They have made me MP. I have full faith on Mamata Banerjee.
When did you speak to her last?
No, that is absolutely personal question. When am I speaking to my leader? It is absolutely personal question. I have full faith on Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee.
And what if they ask you to step down as MP?
I have no information.
Are you under some pressure now?
Or not? No.
Do you know where Sudip?
The thing is, I am a working journalist. I am facing this kind of charges, and after my latest situation is the totally politically motivated charges I am facing.
Are you willing, Mr. Kunal Ghosh, to debate this issue in detail with left leaders who are making several allegations against you? Are you willing to come in an open debate with the left on this subject?
I have no problem, Arnab.
I ask a very small question? No allegation, just one question.
Allow her to ask you one question.
Arnab, please.
One point.
Let her make one point,
Kunal Ghosh. If you don't want to answer, you don't have to.
Thousands of young people on the street who have lost everything, who are scared to go back to their homes.
Financial institutions, they are in Bengal for few years, more than decades. Every media, print media, electronic media, using their funds as advertisement.
Okay, now this debate on the news hour tonight, now what I'll say, I want to say one thing.
Arnab, let me clear one thing.
Anindita, let her please.
Let me respond to your... Arnab, let me respond to your proposal.
Tara News, Tara Music, you were there.
Let him respond before I wrap up. I'm short of time. Kunal Ghosh, last word to you, please. Yes, please.
Arnab, let me respond to your proposal. I have nothing to hide. I am ready to sit with any political leader for a discussion or debate, because politicians, senior politicians of different parties, they know me from my childhood. They have compulsion to make it political issue, but they know that Kunal Ghosh is a hardcore professional. He is not a cheater or fraud. I am working in this profession. From the very morning and midnight, I continue my work with my colleagues. Unfortunately, this happens, and now everybody, they are avoiding their responsibility, and now
Kunal Ghosh,
being the target.
Mr. Kunal Ghosh, with the greatest of respect I have for you, I take up your offer to have a debate on the subject. We'll call left tomorrow. But Mr. Ghosh, you see what happened. The line between journalism and politics is a Lakshman Rekha.
The entire media announced.
Yeah, I understand.
The papers, the channels, they will not receive the advertisement from
Today our heart goes out. Mr. Kunal Ghosh, we'll debate this. Our heart goes out to all those who have suffered, to those who've lost their money, to the families that have been devastated, and to the hundreds of journalists without any fault of theirs who are out on the roads today without a job on the streets of Kolkata. They did not deserve this. And Kunal Ghosh and Anindita will debate this further. Thank you very much for joining me on News Hour Debate tonight. Thank you.